We have privilege questions. This is another type of questions. With the privilege questions, you have to focus on one important thing, which is the Q element. Okay? We have Q element and Q verb. Q element means the question element. Question element. And we have Q verb, it means WH word, the word that you use to ask the question itself. Yeah. The difference between the two, that Q element may consist of Q word, for example, which, when, or a complement within the Q word. So the Q element may consist of the WH word itself plus complement. Okay, so this is a question we have. Which books have, look, which books of this Q element consists of WH word, which, and complement books? In this question, we have only WH word. It means Q element may consist of two words, the WH word and complement, or only one word, which is the Q element or the Q word. In both of them, the Q element occurs initially in the sentence, while the Q word, if it's long, occurs also initially in the element. The rest of the question follows the rule of yes-no question. It means that the operator have will occur before the subject and then the complement of the sentence and so on. So this is the WH question. Of course, when we talk about the WH question and this difference with from the yes-no question, the WH question requires information. It means that we have to supply information. Okay, within WH questions, we have sometimes preposition in the WH question. The preposition may occur initially before the WH word, and this way it consists of the WH or the Q element, or it may occur final in the sentence. No matter how it occurs initial as a question or final, it is a matter of formality. Here it is informal style. The preposition occurs initial in the sentence before the Q element or the WH word, or it is informal when it occurs final in the sentence, not after. Of course, here we have the WH element, okay, the WH word, and the preposition is the complement, which is, of course, complement to the WH question. So, this is in general about WH questions, and we have in English language, we have different words, WH words, that we use. For example, we have the list here on this page, who opened my letter, which box, whose, why, when, where, why, how, and so on. You have the list on page 197. You have to check them. Okay, for each one, it forms a different function. This structure is the same as the WH questions, but the difference we have the WH element or Q element, and the function is different, which is you have to supply information to the listener. The second or another type of questions, the main types of questions, is alternative questions. Alternative questions, it means we have alternatives, we have choices within the question itself. So, here, this type of questions, you ask the listener about something, but at the same time, you give him choices, and the listener can choose one of them. This type of questions is divided into two types. The first one we call yes-no alternative question. We call yes-no alternative question because the question itself begins with operator. We don't have WH word or Q word. And the second type, yeah, we have WH word alternative question. It means that the question starts with WH word. Look at the first one. Here we have an example. Would you like chocolate, vanilla, or strawberry? Look, here you have three choices. One, two, three. The answer will say, I like chocolate, for example. You see, you have choices, and the answer is one of them. The same thing here. Which ice cream would you like? Chocolate and so forth. So you have choices. The difference between the two, that here we have yes, no, alternative question, double-edged alternative question. Sometimes, yes, no question itself, like this one. Are you coming? Are you coming only? This is yes, no question. You can change it into alternative yes, no question. How is that in this way? Are you coming or not? By adding the phrase or not. So now we change it into from yes, no question into yes, no alternative question. Or, not only this is the first option for you, the second one by repeating the question itself. But one of them should be positive, the second one should be negative. So aren't coming or aren't, look here we have negative, aren't you coming? So now we change the yes, no question into yes, no alternative question. And sometimes when you have yes, no question, two questions, but we have identical elements in the same question. Look, did Italy win the World Cup? Or did Brazil win the World Cup? Look, in the second question we have identical elements repeated from the first one. So we have did, we have did. When, we have when. The World Cup, the World Cup. So, in the second question, we don't need to repeat the same or identical elements that are used in the first one. So, we can change this one. We say, did Italy or, okay, Brazil win the World Cup? It means that I abbreviate the two questions into one question, okay? Choose alternative and deleting the repeated elements like did win the World Cup because they are available in the first question. So we move the abbreviated elements, did Italy or Brazil, and then the complication of the sentence, the elements that are not repeated now with the World Cup. With this point, we finish this type of, or the all types of major questions. Next lecture, we are going to talk about the minor questions of questions, the minor types of the questions. We talk about rhetorical questions and exclamation questions. Thank you very much.